So we're going to look at an example that will allow us to derive the formula for calculating a finite geometric series. Suppose a sandwich shop has just come up with a new sandwich. They'd sell 10,000 units of this new sandwich in the first month, and those sales are increasing by 15% each month after that. How many sandwiches did they sell in the last month of the year? How many did they sell during the year total? So we're going to look at both of these. Now, because our number is going up by a constant 15%, we could look at the number of sandwiches sold each month as the terms in a geometric sequence. So the first thing we want to do is recall our formula for calculating the general term of a geometric sequence. It involves the first term, a sub 1, and the common ratio, r. For our problem, our first term is 10,000, and if you remember our study of exponential functions, since we have a 15% increase, our common ratio is actually going to be 1.15. So this will calculate the general term that will give us the number of sandwiches in any given month. We want to do this for the last month of the year, so we're doing it when n equals 12. And so in that last month, we get 46,524 sandwiches. What our goal is to do the amount for the whole year. So we're actually summing up a geometric series. Let's see how we can do that. So again, we'll use S sub n to denote the sum of a series. And we're going to talk about it first doing it for n months. All right. So we're going to add up our terms. So we have 10,000 plus 10,000 times our common ratio plus 10,000 times our common ratio squared, so on and so forth, all the way up to 10,000 times our common ratio to the n minus 1. So what we have here would actually calculate the sum of the number of sandwiches for the first n months. Using 10 instead of 10,000, just to make it a little shorter, we'll convert at the end, and using r to represent the common ratio, which for this problem is 1.15. Now, what we're going to do is a nice little trick that's going to allow us to simplify this. I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by the common ratio. So on the left-hand side, I get r times s sub n. On the right-hand side, I get r times that entire equation. Now, I do need to distribute that r to every single term over there. Once we do that, what we get is almost the exact same thing as s sub n, but each term has one higher degree of r. Here's what's really nice about that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract my two equations because all the middle terms are going to cancel out. So when all said and done, on the left-hand side I get s sub n minus r times s sub n. On the right-hand side, all I get left is 10 minus 10 times r to the n. Everything else canceled. Before I go on, let's remember what our goal is. Our goal is to calculate a nice concise formula to calculate s sub n. Now on that left hand side, we can do a little bit of adjustment. So making a little room here. On the left hand side, I'm going to factor out s sub n. On the right hand side, I'm going to factor out 10, which gives us the following. Take a moment and make sure you can see how those were factored out. Again, remember our goal is to solve for s sub n. So what I'm going to do is divide both sides by 1 minus r, and what I get is a formula for s sub n. Now for our problem, our common ratio was 1.15. So now what we have is a formula that will calculate the total number of sandwiches for n months. So it actually calculates the sum of the geometric series. So let's finish off our problem and then we'll generalize. So for our problem, we're looking for the number of sandwiches during the first year. That means 12 terms, so n is 12. So, in calculating that, we get our 10, which came from our number of sandwiches the first month, times 1 minus 1.15 was our common ratio to the 12th, that's the number of terms, over 1 minus 1.15, which gives us about 290.017. Now remember, I changed 10,000 to 10 to make things a little bit easier, so I do have to multiply this by 1,000. So we're looking at 290,017 sandwiches sold during the first year. Now let's go ahead and generalize this formula for a finite geometric series. It involves the first term, the common ratio, and the number of terms. and this will always find the sum of a finite geometric series.